In these next videos, I'm going to start talking about some U-Substitution. And U-Substitution is typically the first integration technique you learn. And the idea with U-Substitution is you're simply trying to turn an integral into a rather somewhat complicated integral into one that's a little more recognizable. So suppose we have the following problem. Suppose we have 2x, and then we have x squared plus 4, and let's make it raised to the 100 power. Now, if you didn't know anything about U-substitution, and you've seen a little bit of integration, you could simply multiply this thing out. You'd have a whole bunch of terms, and then you could integrate those piece by piece. But probably you wouldn't want to do that. At least I wouldn't want to. The idea is what we're going to do is we're going to do kind of a relabeling scheme. So I'm going to call the stuff on the inside, the x squared plus 4, I'm going to relabel that as u. So I'm going to make u equal to the stuff inside the parentheses. And the trick with U-substitution is look for things that are derivatives of each other. Notice if you take the derivative of this inside stuff, you'll actually get the 2x term. It doesn't have to be exactly the other stuff, as we'll see, but that's usually a clue that U-substitution works. So again, I'm calling U the stuff on the inside. I'm basically taking the derivative of U, which means I have to take the derivative of the right side as well. The derivative of x squared is 2x, 4 becomes 0, and then we tack on a dx. What you're actually doing here is calculating a differential. And notice the stuff inside the parentheses. Now if I go to rewrite this, well, we relabeled x squared plus 4, that's what we called u, so now I have u to the 100 power, and notice my 2x dx that's left over, because again I've replaced the u squared plus 4 raised to the 100 power. The only thing that's left over is the 2x dx term, but that's exactly what du is equal to. And I'm just going to put my du out to the right. And now the idea is this is just a basic integration problem. You've got a variable raised to the 100th power. It's just like having x raised to the 100. Well, you'll get u to the 101. We have to add 1 to the power. Divide by that new power. Plus c. And then the idea is, since you started with x's, you want to stop with x's. Right now we have u's. But simply just use your original substitution and plug that back in. So again, u is the same thing as x squared plus 4 raised to the 101 power divided by 101 plus c. And that will be your antiderivative. So again, U-substitution is just kind of a trick for relabeling things to make it look like a more basic problem. Let's see, let's do some more of these. Suppose I have cosine to the 4th of theta times sine of theta d theta. So again, the thing I recognize here that kind of makes this stand out to me is, well, sine and cosine are derivatives of each other. Yeah, one of them you pick up a negative, but that's okay. As long as you're getting the correct derivative, what they say, up to a constant, U-substitution will work. Remember that cosine of theta to the 4th, you can rewrite that as the following, and I usually like to see these a little bit better. I've gotten used to realizing in my head that they're equivalent, but I used to always rewrite them just to make things a little clearer. Usually whatever's inside the parentheses being raised to a power, a lot of times that's going to be a good guess that that's going to be what u should equal. So I'm going to let u equal cosine of theta. Well, the derivative, or the differential, is going to be negative sine of theta d theta. And notice though, okay, so I'm calling cosine of theta u, so that'll take care of my u to the 4th, and then I have a sine of theta d theta left over. The differential though says I get negative sine theta d theta. Well, I can just multiply both sides by a negative and get negative du equals sine theta d theta, And that's now what I'll replace the sine theta, d theta stuff with. So it says that instead of cosine of theta, that's what I'm calling u, so I'll have u to the fourth. And now the sine theta d theta that's left hanging out, that's what I'm going to plug in for the, I'll plug negative du in for that. Okay, so you can think about the negative as simply being a negative 1, and you can pull that all the way out front if you want to. And again, now all you have to do is integrate. U to the 4th becomes u to the 5th over 5 plus c. And then again, we'll simply plug back in what our original u substitution was back in for u. So it says u was cosine of theta raised to the 5th power divided by 5 plus c. And that will be your antiderivative for this original problem. And you can always check if you take the derivative of this thing, you know, you should get what you were integrating back at the very beginning. Let's see if we can't find one other good problem here. Let's do maybe one tricky one. Okay, so in that problem I had to manipulate the u. Let's do one other one here. Suppose I'm integrating x over the fourth root of x plus 2. Now, usually when I see things off by a power, like an x squared and an x, or maybe x to the ninth and x to the eighth, it really stands out to me that it's u-substitution. But, in fact, this is also a u-substitution problem. Again, if you want to rewrite this, we can make this x over x plus 2 to the 1/4 power. So I'm going to use the same logic in the last one where whatever's being raised to the power, that's what we'll make u equal to. So u is equal to x plus 2. The differential du is simply going to be 1 dx. And if I go to relabel things, I'm going to leave myself a little space here because I'm going to talk about a little bit more. The x plus 2 is equivalent to u, so I've got u to the 1/4. Dx is equivalent to du, all right, there that is. But I still have an x left hanging out that I need to get rid of here. Well, I've got a relationship involving u and x. I can simply subtract 2 and have that u minus 2 is equal to x, and that's what I'll plug in for my x on top, is u minus 2. And now we'll simply break this up. U over u to the 1/4, that's going to become u to the 3/4, minus 2 over u to the 1/4, we'll bring that up and make it to the negative 1/4. And now we'll simply integrate. So u, when we add 4 over 4, I'll get to the 7/4. Dividing by 7/4 is the same thing as multiplying by 4/7. Minus 2, u to the negative 1/4, if I add 4 over 4, I'm going to get u to the 3/4. I'll have to divide by 3/4, which is the same as multiplying by 4/3. Plus c, and again, the last thing I need to do here is replace my u's with my x plus 2 that I had found from the original substitution. And if there's any simplification, I'll do that as well. So I'll have 4/7 u, which is x plus 2, to the 7/4, minus 8/3 u, again, which is x plus 2, to the 3/4, plus c, and there is your antiderivative. So again, u-substitution already becomes a little trickier. Unfortunately, there's much longer and harder integration techniques than u-substitution, but you'll see those soon enough, unfortunately, I guess. So if you want to see some more examples of u-substitution, I've only done indefinite integrals here. I've also got a lot of videos with definite integrals involving u-substitution, along with pretty much every other integration technique as well on my website. So feel free to hop over there and shoot me an email if you got any questions.